guys, thanks for tuning in. Today we're installing the Shark 3000 watt stereo on Redline's Classic Harley.
Okay, first thing is, let's check the box and see what all we got in there. Start off with, we've got the 8800 chrome Shark 3000 watt stereo. This comes in black. Also, what we've added on here now is waterproofing for the front and the back. One thing you need to know about this when you're deciding on where you're going to put this is you don't have to get to this unit. You put this unit in there, plug everything in, and everything's going to work on the remote control. You can run it with the buttons on the front if you want to, but the point is it doesn't have to be accessible. So if you're putting it on your boat, there's mounting brackets on both sides. You can mount it up underneath your dash, be done with it, and work everything from your remote. Everything's plug and play. It's real simple. What else we got in here is, okay, this is gonna be your connection. This is how simple it is. Red, positive, black, negative. That's your ground. So this is gonna go directly on your power source, and it plugs in the back of your unit right there. It also has in between a fusible link, which is a very good option to have in case you get a power dump. It's gonna blow your fuse before it blows your unit. I'm not sure what size that is. I'm gonna guess that's a 5 amp. Don't quote me on it. We'll figure that out later. Now, here's what I was talking about. This is the remote control that you're gonna run your entire unit from. Once again, it's plug and play. Very simple. It comes with spacers in here, so this will fit on your standard 1-inch bars. If you have eighth hangers like I've got on Fuego, I've got 1 1/8 inch, 1 1/2 inch, all the way up to 2 inch, this is gonna fit. It's got just an easy work thumb screw right there. You take out the spacers you don't want. On here is your power button and also your select mode button. This is gonna change you from FM to your memory card to Bluetooth, back and forth, and cycle it that way. The channel up, channel down, just what it says. If you're on FM, it's gonna go channel up, channel down. Now, if you're cycling your music, if you've got everything on shuffle, this is just gonna shuffle your music up and down. Volume up, volume down. It's that simple. Also in here, we've got an antenna. This looks to be a bigger antenna than the one that I've seen on the 1500 watt. It's also easy connect. It's just gonna screw in the back of your unit like that and affix it with some two-sided tape or some Velcro, put it somewhere out of the way, be done with it. I live in the DFW Metroplex. I'm not gonna have trouble getting signals. If you live way out in the middle of Wyoming, Kansas, Nebraska, somewhere, you may have trouble. It'll be interesting to see how powerful this antenna is. I'm gonna be headed up to Arkansas to go ride the pig trail here soon, and we'll see just how powerful that antenna is. What else we got in here? Oh, it also comes with another remote that you can work. Let's say you've ridden 7.5 hours, you're tired, you pull over to a rest stop, you want to take a break, but you want some tunes, you don't feel like walking over to your bike, bam, right here. You can run everything from this remote control. That easy. Here we have, apparently, directions. I'm a guy, I don't read directions. Here's the speakers. These are beautiful. It comes with the system that I have, came with 8 speakers. I'm obviously not gonna be able to put 8 speakers on my bike, but if you have a boat, 8 speakers will go on there and you'll rock that lake. It comes with already, you can see here, that shows it a little bit better, handlebar mounts. This is made to mount on your handlebar, one plug, and you're done with it. It's waterproof, it's weatherproof. You don't have to worry about it getting hot. You don't have to worry about it getting cold or wet. It's gonna work. Oh, and also, they even stuck the Allen wrenches in there that you need to install it. Couldn't be easier than that. So let's get busy installing this. I'm gonna put two speakers on the front, and then we're gonna check it out and see how loud it is. If you have a touring model, you can easily put two more speakers back there on your Razor trunk and be good to go. Eight speakers, you can probably get six on an ATV. You can definitely get all eight on a boat, and you're gonna rock that lake. So let's get busy and see how this sounds. Okay, one of the first things you're gonna have to do is you have to locate your power source. I got a Harley, so all I gotta do is I gotta take this bolt out right here. I got a little thumb bolt right here. Take the seat off, like that. Bam, right there at the battery. So wherever your power source is, open that up first, and then we'll get to the connection. Okay, the way that these connectors are, you don't have to take the screw all the way out. So just back the screw out a bit, put it in there, tighten it down. Make sure you get your screws good and tight, or bolts if you have it, because the vibration will rock these loose and you'll be somewhere and she won't start, and you'll look everywhere, think your starter's out, your battery's dead, and all it is you got a loose connection. So now then we're gonna install our ground. And that's all there is to install it. Now then all we gotta do is hide our power cord, go connect it to the unit, and then start connecting our speakers. To connect the power, all you have to do, take this end of the connection here and put it right here in the back of the unit, just like that. Now you're connected. Next thing we wanna do is we wanna mount the speakers. What you're gonna do that is you're gonna take that Allen wrench that they gave you, and you're gonna take these two little bolts out of the mounting bracket. And it's going to come apart into two pieces. Take that one out. And this one, what just fell out was one of the spacers. This is because this will work on, like I said, on the same thing on your remote control. It's going to work on an inch, inch and a half, all the way up to a 2-inch bar. So I've got an inch and an eighth, so we may or may not need one of these spacers. We're going to find out. Now we got our speakers mounted. We can connect them. Just plug and play. Top row is going to be your left. Bottom row is going to be your right. Now then, to install the antenna, you're going to need to remove this little red plastic thing right there, and then you're going to screw this in right here on the end of your unit, and then mount your antenna wherever it's out of the way, and then you're ready for AM/FM. Next thing we're going to install is the remote control. What I've done is I've taken all the spacers out, because I've got pretty thick bars, removed the thumb screw, and to make it a little easier, you can take the actual unit off of the bracket and then install the bracket and slide the unit right back on there. So this is going to go on your handlebar. Okay, we've got the remote control installed, and I realize that I've been saying AM, FM, and I don't even know if AM exists anymore. It's got FM, MP3, and it will run Bluetooth. And to install it, you just plug this in on the exact opposite side where you put the power. And now then, we're gonna tuck wires, fire it up, and see what we got. Now then, to hook up your Bluetooth, you're just gonna go to your camera, your smartphone, go to your connections, hit Bluetooth, and you're gonna see it shows up right there. Shows up as Shark. It's Shark, and it's gonna connect. We've got a song playing now.
The Bluetooth device is ready to pair.
I'm not sure what she's saying. Now I'm on FM. Now then it's connecting to Bluetooth. All right, here we go. Let's fire up the tunes. Yeah. voice or not. That was a bumpy ass road. Let's do this. Okay, my final review on the Shark 3000 watt water resistant stereo system is, out of 5 stars, I give it a 5. I don't know if you could tell on the video or not how loud it was, because there's a lot of wind noise on the camera, but it is plenty loud at 80 miles an hour. You can hear the song crystal clear. It's easy to install and it's at a great price. I've got the extra speakers. I'm not going to put 8 speakers on my bike, obviously, but it's worth the price, and I do recommend that you pick up a Shark. Go for the 3000 watt. Don't mess around with low wattage. The louder the better. I ride a Harley, my pops are loud, and I can hear the songs good on it. So 5 stars for the Shark. I am Redline, and I am out of here.